afraid of the dark, Dad. Can I sit with you until I fall asleep?
But Jenny, God was with you even in the dark.
I know that, Dad. But I want someone beside me with skin on.
All right, Jenny, I'll sit with you. How about a special song? This song tells you how God loved you so much that he came to earth with skin on. Thou didst leave thy throne and thy kingly crown when thou camest to earth for me. But in Bethlehem's home was there found no room for thy holy nativity. Oh, come to my heart, Lord Jesus. There is room in my heart for thee.
I like that, Dad. I want the Lord Jesus to come in my heart. I have room in my heart for him.
That's good, honey. And that song tells us a wonderful truth. God wants his son to come and live in our hearts. He lives there by faith when we love him. The innkeeper had no room for him. But you and I can have room for him in our hearts. That's what God wants each one of us to know.
Dad, will you tell the story again?
All right, honey.
Our Christmas program will emphasize the truth of the incarnation through Christmas carols. These carols serve to write this story indelibly in our minds. May we rejoice and sing in our hearts to the Lord as we share in hearing the Christmas story in carols. Do you realize the far-reaching value this has in your life? Jesus Christ, part of the eternal Godhead, became a man in flesh and blood, and came here from heaven to dwell with us on earth, with skin on. God gave us a living link to himself by sending his son to earth. Now we have a living hope because Jesus Christ, the Word from God, became flesh and dwelt here among us. For a brief time, God drew back the curtain and gave us a look at eternity. Jesus Christ was the vital link between God and man, and he came to be born in Bethlehem's manger.
Dad, why was God willing to give up his son? Did he miss him? Did he cry?
Oh yes, it made him sad, Jenny. But let's go through the story and it'll explain his position. God loved us so much that he wanted to send his son here to earth, even knowing his son had to die for us. God knew that was the only way that he could forgive our sins and take us to live with him in heaven someday. And so, Jenny, a long, long time ago, it says here that the governor issued a decree that everyone should go to his own town to be registered. Mary and Joseph traveled to Bethlehem because he was of the house and lineage of David. But they couldn't find any room in the inn. You see, all the inn was totally full. The town was crowded with travelers all coming to be counted too. But Mary's time was near for Jesus to be born. So Joseph convinced the innkeeper to let them stay in the stable. Joseph led their donkey around to the stable and fed him. You see right here where he is right here? Then Joseph fixed a place in the clean hay where Mary could lie down to rest. That night in Bethlehem, Jesus was born. God sent his only son to be born in a humble stable in this little town.
Oh,
I'm glad he came too, Jenny. If Jesus hadn't come to Earth, we would have no hope. And Jesus didn't arrive here as a king would come. He had no chariot to ride, no crown to wear, and no throne. So no one treated him like a king at all. He came, born a baby in Bethlehem, wrapped in swaddling clothes, and laid in a manger.
God sent his son to earth in human flesh so he could tell all and show us all God wanted us to know.
Born to be our friend, he
In chapter 1, verse 1 and 2 tells us, "In the past, God spoke to our forefathers through the prophets at many times in various ways. But in these days, he has spoken to us by his Son, whom he appointed heir of all things, and through whom he made the universe."
I hope you behave better than 2 and 3-year-olds when I ask you to sing. Actually, they're so cute, and they were scared in the dark is what I think happened. But why don't you open this, inside you find an insert.
Is that the good news of great joy?
Oh yes, it was good news to all men. It has brought great joy ever since to those who find room for Jesus Christ in their hearts. What a joy. Imagine, Jenny, God came to earth with skin on.
And suddenly, a great multitude of angels appeared saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace, goodwill among men."
Let's join the angels with a heart the herald angels sing. You'll find that in a little bit.
A great Christmas. The Word from God became flesh and blood and dwelt here among us. We no longer needed a tabernacle or a temple. Now God dwells in the hearts of those who have room for Him.
The shepherds found the stable in Bethlehem. They fell on their knees before this baby and worshiped God. See how they did that? This was God's gift to men. They saw this baby lying on the hay, wrapped in swaddling clothes, just as the angel had said.
I wish I'd been there.
Me too. And one big shepherd reached out and touched the baby's hand. And the baby wrapped his tiny fingers around one finger of the big shepherd. His heart pounded. "I've touched the Son of God," he exclaimed. This was God's promised son. He came to set men free. No wonder the shepherds left, rejoicing and praising God. They'd seen him. They'd touched him. He was real. Heaven's arches rang when the angels sang, proclaiming thy royal decree. But of lowly birth did thou come to earth, and in greatest humility. Oh, come to my heart, Lord Jesus, there is room in my heart for thee.
Silent night.
And there were wise men who diligently studied the stars to find out where their Messiah would be born. And these wise men followed that star until it came and stood over the house where Mary and Joseph lived.
Best of all, eternal life starts now, if we love Jesus. I'm glad you have given room in your heart, Jenny. Now, it's time for your pajamas and time to go to bed.
Dad?
Yes, Jenny?
I'm not afraid anymore. Now that I know Jesus is living in my heart, I have someone here all the time with skin on.
Good night, honey. I'm thankful that he's in my heart, too. I wish everyone could know the true joy of Christmas. The King stole Lord with the living word that should set thy people free. But with mocking scorn and with crown of thorn, they bore thee to Calvary. Oh, come to my heart, Lord Jesus. There is room in my heart for thee.
Thank you. Good job, Jake.
Really good. Hang in there now.
Get your head.
Excellent. Excellent. Good turn. Take your boat in now. Dock in. Let out your sheet. Go. Good. Excellent.
Good job, Jacob.
Hey, you did a great job.
Thank you. Mom, I get to go out there.
Good job, Jake.
You wear a dark helmet?
Yes, ma'am. I'm taping Chris.
In the white sailboat.
Watch your head. Watch your head!
Mom, the reason why... Heather, she's going last, and the wind keeps picking up, so.
That's all right.
Good job, Chris.
Just don't get your tiller caught in it. There you go.
Okay, now where do I turn?
Inside.
Go to the inside now. Go.
Port side, right?
Port side.
That's
the left side.
That's the right side for him.
No, port side's left side.
No, but that's the right side.
Watch your head, Chris. Good job, Chris. Whoops.
Oh, the other side. That's okay. All right.
You can just go back in.
Come up this way.
The starboard side. The starboard.
Now that's a good tack. Good going.
Whoops.
Take it back into the dock now. Come up on this side and then take it into the dock.
Great job, Chris.
I get a sail out in the main ocean. See, I mean, lake.
You'll catch it.
Heather, the wind's picking up.
Now, somebody watching Heather move. I am. Watch your head, Heather.
She went the wrong way.
She's fine. Watch your head. Good job, Heather. Good job.
Hey, you guys, we're on the air. We're going to be needing to sail this boat out of here.
Is anybody watching her? Good job, Heather. Josh, be ready to watch to get Jacob if you need to. Oh, he's in irons, isn't he?
Yep. What?
Anybody else go?
You ready to go out?
No.
Where did everybody else go?
I don't know. They were going to go over and see if they could get one more book.
Should I go get him?
There he goes. Good job, Jake. Good job. Think about what you're doing. Uh-oh. Turn it all the way around.
Down for the boom.
Watch the boom. Get over the side, babe. I think he's gonna come back in now. I know it. I'll be the first to admit it. Watch your head. Pay attention to what you're doing. Not me. Looking at me instead of.
That's why you're not supposed to do that, Mom. It makes.
You pay attention to what you're doing, not me.
You guys on the boat?
No. That's my brother right there.
You sail before?
Yeah, a little bit. I sail a little bit.
Okay.
You're going into the wind.
You like it here? Not over here.
Good job, Adam.
Long drive.
Okay, it's fun.
Oh, I didn't do that yet.
Do you like this boat?
Okay.
Do you like it?